People are capable of looking after their own lives. If it's a matter of education, it's not just sugar, it's a whole range of other things. If we want to turn back the potential tsunami of obesity that's coming, let's be frank and open and look at a whole lot of products that are not good for people and try and turn people around by way of education. But to have some namby-pamby state say you can't have this, you can't have that, it's not what we should be doing as a country. We should be ensuring that people understand what's good for them and what's bad.
But Mr. Peters, don't they know that already? Don't they know that Coke is bad for them, that too much junk food is bad for them? And haven't they proven that actually they're not capable of looking after themselves? We have skyrocketing obesity rates, heart disease rates, type 2 diabetes rates.
Well, if you want to go on an evangelistic mission to turn people around without their consent, then you go right ahead. But the fact is, there is Coke Zero.
Are you a fan of Coke Zero?
There are soft drinks which have... well, don't change the subject. This is a serious matter.
I agree.
It's about the future health problems we've got, in the Polynesian world in particular, in the Maori world in particular, but now amongst a lot of Asian youth and also significant number of people who are European. So we should be out there trying to ensure that we give people the right information early in life and make good food cheap enough.
Okay.
Good food cheap enough and fruit and things like that. What this argument should be about, not somebody in an ivory tower on a high-blown salary telling New Zealanders what they should and shouldn't do and legislating for it.